Hello, welcome to Multimodal 2021. I'm going to be speaking to Ty with Matt and Bryce. We're going to be talking about tracking. Matt, question for you first off. What are your views about the current climate with the supply chain?
Well, it's certainly exposed a lot of vulnerabilities. It's certainly made, logistics is definitely having a moment. So I think for us at Tide, what it's all about is, we've seen a big increase in inquiries, customers coming to us with problems or looking for solutions. So for us, it's been a busy time. But also, at the same time, we've had to work very closely with our customers, providing them with visibility and the data that they need to help them get through it, really.
So are you getting more requests for more data, that sort of thing? Do people understand what you do a bit better, maybe?
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
And have you come out with any solutions that have come from these challenges? Anything new?
Yeah, what we have seen, to complement a bit what Matt was saying, is you have seen with the microprocessor like crisis, with the vaccines, with the Brexit, that people, companies, and as well as logistics providers have realized that they don't have any visibility at all at the moment. So they just realized that, and they need a bit more predictability. So they realize that they need a bit of more real-time data. And what we offer actually brings this, because we bring location, we bring condition around the products, we bring security. And all the problematics which are like quite hot at the moment in the market. So that's why I think we see a bit of rise of level of the inquiries.
Do you feel that there are still consumers out there, your customers, who may be worried about that transparency? How do you talk to them about sharing data, using data, that sort of thing?
So they're certainly not worried about it. There's a great demand for it. And the way it's being used is especially because of problems thrown up by the supply chain or within shipping, they want more data. Mm-hmm. So, we're able to put our devices on shipments that go anywhere in the world. And we can basically, give our customer information about how this shipment has behaved. So where it stopped, maybe it stopped in a place or a port for much longer than it needed to. Our customers could even see if these are on container ships waiting outside Los Angeles.
Okay.
If they've got containers on a vessel that's in a queue in Asia or in California, they're able to see all that information. From a functionality point of view, it's as simple for one of our customers to say share shipment. So they can click a button and they get a URL, and then they can share that link with customers or any organization outside their own business, and they can see where that shipment is in real time.
Okay, so presumably people are asking for more of that data because now they've realized the flaws in the supply chain or that there's a bit of a problem, they want more data.
Yeah, it's definitely like comparing against service level agreements.
Right.
So to see where there's the ability to say, okay, well, you're supposed to be providing us with a shipment service, you're not performing, we need to renegotiate. And here's where...
So accountability and also understanding pinch points and what you can do. Yeah.
Exactly.
And you talked about transparency. I think what we realize is the market is quite fragmented. So you have players like what Matt was saying about, we want to share more data, we want to share shipments. What people are looking for is to have the same level of information. And at the end of the day is to basically consolidate the supply chain within one level of information, combining technologies and having like more data, and basically not fight to each other
exactly,
of claims, but more like prevent the incidents to happen in the first place and be more proactive and people having more knowledge. And I think that's why now a solution like ours and the visibility market is having a moment, is because people are realizing that they need to have a real supply chain and not supply chains, I would say.
Right. Yeah. Right, so you're giving them that visibility so they can make smart business decisions and they can see where the pinch points are.
Exactly.
Right? Okay, fantastic. So, Bryce, what are the emerging trends and the big challenges that your customers are asking for help for?
So, we have several, because what we see in the transportation industry in general is an industry which is riddled with unpredictability, inefficiencies, and one of them is basically like delays, products missing opportunities because they don't arrive on time, or product loss, like I don't know how much it is, but 100 billions, I think, per year. So like the changes that people have is what we said about the data, they keep preventing these delays, having to predict less stock, prevent product being lost, right. And basically like be what we said, more proactive and have a better supply chains and all the actors working together towards having a lean type of logistics chain, I would say.
Right. So there's actually lots of lessons to be learned from these challenges, right? To make it better.
Yeah.
Okay, fantastic. How does Tive help companies who are affected by all of this?
So, I mean, just on the trends question, I mean, one thing I'm hearing a lot of this morning, and I think it's going to be a future trend, is about the middle mile.
Okay.
So like middle mile security and condition monitoring. So we've had conversations about shipment integrity between the warehouse and the retailer. So I'm hearing a lot about that. And I think, you know, we've got customers who are saying to us, well, can your device measure shock? So we want to know how shipments being handled.
Right.
So especially as e-commerce has boomed, right?
Yeah.
So, you know, customers are perhaps calling saying, well, we're rejecting this shipment because it's damaged.
Right.
So one of the trends is trying to bring them level of rejections down.
Okay.
Or put that level of accountability to see exactly where it's happened.
Right.
So we're even being asked about being able to use these inside warehouses.
Okay.
One thing we've been able to do with our platform are create different legs. So we can have a road leg, an ocean leg, or an air leg, and that leg can end at a warehouse. And then we can kind of activate the shock element just when the shipment's in the warehouse.
Okay.
So a lot of customers, they're saying, okay, we want to know how shipments are handled in warehouses.
Right.
They're being dropped or mishandled or whatever. So I think, you know, what we're trying to do is kind of help those customers who are very focused on the integrity and the condition monitoring.
So maybe too much emphasis on the final mile, and now actually what we need to make sure is that it gets there, and whilst it's being transported,
correct,
it's safe.
Yeah.
Correct.
Does that also work with temperature?
Yep. So temperature is an important one, and again, me and Bryce, we've had a chat with a company this morning about food shipment temperature monitoring.
Right.
Yeah, that's a big one for us.
So that's a big emerging one as well, as we're watching all this stuff happening,
Exactly, because if you think as well, you may have insurance as well, which may be interested in having, we spoke same company actually, about collecting data over time to have a better profile around risks, which will help customers actually, like, and insurance companies to actually, like, for the customer to reduce the cost of the premium, and the insurance obviously to pay the same customers.
So making smart business decisions based on the data that you're doing.
Okay. And on top of this, we have, like, we spoke about trends, but we have different sides. We have the inbounds, which may affect production, and we have the outbounds, and we realize that our customers are in the entire chain of the logistics.
Okay, and so you can help them with all of those processes.
Yeah, the other way we're looking to help customers is, like, we get some saying, okay, we've got a green agenda.
Okay, yes.
So can you help us with our green agenda? So quite often it's about shortening shipping times and the amount of shipping miles that have been consumed. So again, with visibility, you're able to do that. You can see where shipments are taking too long, and then you can also work out how to shorten them.
Okay.
So that fits into, you know, kind of CO2 usage.
So the big sustainability
usage
agenda, which is on everyone's agenda, but you can actually provide data so they can make a change.
Exactly, yeah.
Okay, that's the big thing at the moment, isn't it?
Yeah.
Sure, rightly so. Matt, what's next for Tive?
Well, what's next is to keep doing what we've been doing, which is, well, I think we've gone 13 quarters where we've beaten each quarter. So we've had 13 quarters of great straight growth. So that's really exciting. I mean, we're going to continue in terms of product development. And I think, you know, we're going to look into expanding our scope, certainly in Europe.
Okay.
And use cases and industries, food is a big emerging market.
Right.
We're seeing a lot of interest in pharmaceuticals.
Sure.
We've done quite a lot of COVID vaccine tracking already.
Yeah.
So yeah, certainly, you know, carry on what we're doing, but and keep growing, yeah.
And we, what we try to emphasize is the innovation.
Yeah.
We really believe that to have data, it's collecting the quality data, and we always like try to define the pace of this visibility market. So for instance, we are the first one to launch the first single-use 5G. We have a non-lithium version of it. We are talking about sustainability.
Yes.
We have a non-lithium version of the tracker.
Okay.
And talking about the pharma that Matt was saying just now, we'll have like a version of our tracker which will go to minus 100 degrees.
Oh, okay.
And minus 200 degrees.
Okay.
For pharma, fully certified, which will help us to help our pharma clients even more than we do now. So
yeah,
we are always pushing on the hardware side a lot, and on the software to provide more reports, analytics, to have this data, like to provide really real quality data to the customers.
Proper insights that people can use, right? Just out of interest, how easy is it to convince people that they can use that data? Do you know what I mean? Sometimes people get overwhelmed with all this data. They ask for it and then they don't use it. How do you guys go about explaining to them how to use it?
Yeah. So you have two ways. So the first one is basically we try to make our platform as user-friendly as possible.
Uh-huh.
So you can customize most everything, the reports. That's one. So how you use it. The second one, we are able to integrate our data to the systems of the clients. So we have an easy API integration.
Okay.
So for instance, if for the planning team, you will have data directly to their own systems. So that's another one. Is and basically the other one is basically to have like the most comprehensive analytics. And what we launched like very recently, I think it was back to April, we have a part of our team which is dealing with alerts, incidents for our customers. So as you said, they are bombarded by alerts potentially.
Yeah.
So we receive instructions from our clients to say, in case you have, for instance, a security breach, that's the people you need to contact, and that's the way what you should do. And we have a team dedicated to do this for customers, which
so it's proper exemption management, basically.
Exactly.
They can react proactively.
On behalf of the customer.
Okay.
What we, I don't know if you, I quite like that quotation, you know, the Alexander the Great quotation about my logisticians are a miserable lot because they're always the first ones I'll slay if the campaign goes wrong. we have our strapline is every shipment matters.
Yeah.
So, I mean, you know, we're here for logisticians and to make their life easier. And we kind of break it down to quite simple little bits of information. So, like, with our Pharma Ready product, which is like 3-point calibration temperature, and, you know, if you look at the data, you can just select the temperature you're interested
in.
You just highlight that. And then it'll show you where in the world, let's say, then temperature spikes happened. So we try and present it very in a user-friendly way, make it fun to use, enjoyable to use. And quite often, like, you'll get feedback from a customer and it's like, oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Quite often it's a shipment's gone in different ports or, you know, different unusual things have happened.
Yeah.
So it's good feedback.
It also means that then they can take action, and that's what it's all about, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot.
For your time.
Thanks.